When we talk about software, and when we talk about data, and when we talk about the impacts on the companies, we all need to realize what we are striving for. We are striving for to have an experience. Whatever we do today in our companies, whatever we build in our softwares, whatever we talk about and implement it in our company's behaviors, what we need to do and what we are trying to achieve is the change in the behavior and to get a better experience. That's the purpose. That's what we are trying to achieve. And that's something we strive for. What we are trying today over here is to talk about that how these softwares, how these companies, how this experience can change so that we can make an impact on our lives, on the people's lives, on the companies that we work for, and most importantly, the ecosystem that we all connect. It's easy to build a software. It's easy to talk about how can we implement it. But what we need to discuss today over here is what is that we want the behavior out of this software that we are talking about? What is the impact on the life of the employee that we are working for? What is the impact on the people around us and what that company wants to achieve? That's how we connect to the software and how we connect to the data. We have talked about in the first session, there's a lot of data available. There's a lot of information. But the most important part is how we connect this whole data into a whole point to get a best experience that we can provide to our customers. Experience management is the key. Everybody wants to connect with some human value that we have. We want to be happy, we want to be amused. We have all the different conditions that we go along, and that's what we need to connect back at how we are going to impact the life of the people. Just think about 20 years back. When we were working with one desktop computers in our offices, and how much time it was taking to have one complete block completing or ending to a point where we achieve the results. Then we just down the road. Everything has changed. The time to achieve the desired result has changed. To be honest, the result that we want to achieve has changed. I'm looking for all our ecosystem and data system to achieve the best result and best financial numbers for our company. That has gone down. What we want to achieve today is something that we can make an impact on the lives of people. Just think over it. Some of the facts. Today, we try to procure from different companies. One of the facts that is happening all across the world is now we are trying to procure from the companies that have a vision that connects to the betterment of the life of the people. Today, we are ready to buy expensive products from those companies because we are thinking about that they are giving back to humanity. We are trying to change their experience completely from one team to another. And that's what we need to connect to our end. Softwares will come and go. The impacts has to be retained over there. What we are doing today in Pakistan is we are going and changing that transformation journey. Whenever we talk about transformation, whenever we talk about change, people resist. People feel that this software will come and it will change their jobs. People resist because they feel they have been trained on a certain process for a long while, and if that process is going to change, they will be exposed. People feel that once this change benefit will come, the whole industry will wipe away and what will happen to their jobs and the people that are attending to these jobs as well. We all fear. Today, the most important part of this experience management or this interview network is we need to understand how we can make an impact on people's life and make them that they are going to be better working in the future. That's what we need to achieve that. You know, we can talk about, and I can talk about how the great companies of SAPs and the Microsoft and the Oracle of the world and iPhone of the world are, but that's not the point. We all know that these companies are great and they are doing the great software out there. What we need to connect over here is how we can make that change in Pakistan. We have all the developed countries, we know how they are working on. We have a certain position in this whole ecosystem here. Pakistan is a certain financial institution. Pakistan has human resources with a 20 million population. And on top of that, Pakistan has the complete startup ecosystem where people are working and going ahead and trying to achieve the results. Think about this startup community that we are talking about today. What they are trying to achieve? They are trying to make the life easier. They are trying to connect to the people's heart and see And what we, the companies that we call the multinationals, what we need to do is to provide the ecosystem so that we can help them making these things better. We need to help them out over there that these software that they are building in, we make them part of our system so that they can get the reach that they are looking for. You know, the multinationals that they are providing is they're getting these startups of Pakistan. We are connecting them to our software and providing them to the whole world. That's the image, that's the reach that we need to provide to all these companies. The whole way of our working has completely changed. If you go back again 25 years back, I remember we used to have a complete paper environment. I quote it in one of my other talks, and I quote it over and again. The guy who was on the top was the gray-haired guy who had all that experience in his head. Because the experience was not part of the machines. By 2005 and 10, all the experience that we are talking about, which was in our head, which was in our files, it started going into the computers. And the power of that old divided man going to get less because the power was shifting to the knowledge and data that was going into the computers. We reached by 2015, majority of the data and experience has been caught up by the machines, and we can get work by a 15-year-old younger guy who can come and work on this experience and achieve a result. What we are seeing in this room, I see the people from 60 plus to the age of 20 plus. And I tell you, they all are competing with each other. Because the data that we are experience that we are talking about, it's there in the software that we are talking about. And if we are not adapting ourselves, if we are not learning, if we are not unlearning and learning again, if we are not realizing that how we have to make ourselves go along with these centennials and millennials that we are talking about. You know what of the studies that have happened? By 2030, the guys who will be running on top of the companies, they will be born after 2000. Think about it. Think about your younger brothers and sisters. Think about your kids, how they think, how they evolution that they go around. How they talk about that we want to use our minds not for the machines that we're working on. My A-level kid told me the other day, I don't know why you're so proud of doing the calculation on your head. Why don't you go on computers when the machine is there? That's the learning pattern of these kids. And they are going to be the decision makers on top of these companies that they are working for. We talk about the young prime minister, we talk about the young entrepreneurs who are leading the CEO positions. They are all around the age of 40 and they are going down. Their decision making patterns are completely different from the way it used to work. And we need to adopt it. We need to understand how the world is adopted. One of the major issues that we are coming is how our behaviors are getting impacted by all these softwares or the data that we are on board. There's a lot of discussion, there's a lot of data, what we do with this data, how we do it in cloud, how we do it in on-prem. This is something that is more practical things. Think about what is happening on your dinner table today. We have four guys having a computer, one kid, one son, talking on the laptop and seeing the screen of your mobile and not connecting with each other. We need to make sure that how we connect with our society and make that behavioral impact in a much better way. Such forums, they provide us to think and then we go back to our companies and see how we can make that impact much better. The purpose of such forum is to come back and see and think over that how fast this whole ecosystem is working with this IT and softwares, but how we can connect back to our lives. The softwares that we work on, the data that we work on, that is not only connected with the machine and the company that we work. That connects with every person that we connect in our ecosystem. That can be our employee, that can be our peer, that can be my son, that can be my father. They all are getting connected and having the impact of these softwares that are working around all around us. We talk about experience. Have you noticed in recent times when you go along and go on an international trip, even if you take Emirates, at the end of the flight when you show you these five places, are you happy? Is the situation bad? Did you like it? It's average. That is the whole end result that company are looking for. That is your final customer that you are working for is happy or not. If that customer for which that whole software ecosystem that we are trying to achieve, the data, the analysis that we are trying to achieve, is he achieving the results and happy or not? We need to think and change our whole psyche. We need to think over how we can make our end customer happy. there's a lot of data that is available. But the issue is, all this data is available like these 40 tables all across the different places. What we need to do is to collect this data to one platform, one intelligent platform that we talk about. The issue with us is, we have a lot of data, it's saturated places out over there, and we feel we are getting the result of it. Imagine the point, we are talking about personalized things today. We are talking about when you enter a mall, you suddenly see you got a coffee here, you got a Pizza Hut, SMS out over there, because they know you were eating it just 2 weeks back in the same place. There is no information of yours that is yours. You provide it yourself. Through your Facebook, through your Instagram, through your likes, through your dislikes, you provide us and you provide the information to all these companies. What is your thinking pattern? How you will behave in a certain situation? How this behavioral function can be done by software and adopt? You know, if you are living with your parents and with yourself, you exactly know over the period of time how they will behave in a situation of anger, how they will behave in the situation of when there is a sunny, sunny situation. This is what machines do. Machine analyzing. They exactly know how it will behave, and 90% of time their analysis is correct. This is what we humans do as well. The only thing that we have done is that we have put this analyzation in the machines, in the software, in the data, and now this is learning fast. And this is getting an issue for us. Issue for us in a way, because our behaviors are getting impacted. Because the people in the system around us know much more than what we predict. We get fearful that how this information that we are talking about comes back to us with all the different channels. So one of the key messages for us today is, think about how we can put this all information at one place and connect to one platform. Unless we don't have that one intelligent platform connected, all the people will take the input from that platform. And that is the intelligent enterprise that we are talking about today. That is the theory that we are talking about today. That is the connection that needs to be established by all the industries to get connected today. Today we need to know when one person goes out, what is its input and output data, which back it is connected out over there, what is the last transaction it did, what was the last thing that he ate. That's the kind of information that will help us to grow. This is the part of the technology. But on the human front, we need to understand how we have to manage this change as well. You know, we all are part of this change so fast, we are not realizing what is the impact on our lives of this. And that's the impact that as a society we need to understand. The Western society has a different impact. We come from our culture, we come from our religion, we come from different aspects, and we need to make sure that what these softwares are impacting, how we can make it connected with our families, how we are connected with our system, our society, our ecosystem, how we can make benefit of this. And that's where we need to lead. That's where the people in this room who are in the leading position in their organization need to decide how they can have a vision, have a mission in what they would like to achieve or buy from this software. Don't buy the software just for the sake of you are going to get better financial result. Buy it with a thought process that how you can achieve something better for the ecosystem. That will make a change. And let's not be afraid of what we learn today and tomorrow will also be there. In old times, when we have learned something that remains as an asset for our whole life, and that's what we build our careers upon. Today, if you are 3 years in an organization and you have not learned something new, trust me, after 5 years, this whole ecosystem will obsolete you. You will be outdated. And that's the fear we all carry in this. The only way we can come over that fear is if we are ready to that, adapt and change that fear. And that's something that we need to connect. I could have come over here and would have talked about how great SAP is, which remains the great company that we work for. But I think the important message today towards this, get a better experience. Get this all data that we are talking about connected with each other through that intelligent enterprise that we talk about. We have all the software working in the cloud right now, working on the on-premise that cloud. Do what is best for your company and for the ecosystem. That's the only way we can bring the change. Always connect each action of yours that it is back to the society. Understanding you cannot make this connect, you will always be clueless why you are doing this job, why you are doing this work, why and what we can achieve. That's what we have to achieve, and then I will say thank you very much. If I go back to the video, it talked about 27 different aspects of human behavior that impacts in our decision making. And we don't realize that how this E each impact is important and how our customers have all these 27 impacts. And when we are putting something up in front of them, we need to make sure we impact these 27 different impacts in their lives. We all pass through these phases. We all pass through the experiences. And we need to make our experiences much better so that we can just connect them. Because trust me, nobody will remember what I bought a suit for a certain place. Somebody will definitely remember what is the experience that he got when he got out of the flight and what is the air that he felt at every point of time. We remember experiences. We connect to experiences. And that's how we can make a change in the ecosystem, in the society, and in the software world. Thank you.